Hey everybody and welcome to our channel, Nessa and Sophie. My name is Nessa and this here is my Cavapoo puppy named Sophie. And today's video has been requested by quite a few of you. You guys are looking for an update on Sophie's eating habits. You guys know that Sophie is a very picky eater. This is just part of the Cavapoo nature. I know a lot of you guys are also dealing with picky eaters as well when you own a Cavapoo. So I thought I would update this video. So I did do a video in the past all about tips and tricks on how to get your puppy to eat. It's got a lot of great tips. I'm going to include the link down in the description box. Now, I am updating that video today because Sophie's eating habits have changed. So a lot of the things that I showed you in that video aren't really working as well anymore, and it makes sense because when you have a fussy eater, they're going to change and they're going to want new and exciting things in order to convince them to eat their food. Today I'm going to share with you three things that I definitely think you should try out if you have a picky eater, and then I'm also going to share with you my number one tool that I'm currently using to get Sophie to eat, and I honestly wish I had tried this out sooner because it is the only thing that's getting her to eat, and I want you guys to test it out as well if you're able to, so make sure you stick around so you can hear what that tool is. So let's get into it. My first tip would be to try different brands and different types of proteins. My pet store is really awesome. They allow me to purchase food, try it out because it doesn't take very long for your dog to show you whether they like their food or not, and then they donate any returns to local pet shelters. So see if your pet store does the same thing as well. With Sophie, I have tried tons of different brands, tons of different proteins, and now that she's an adult, there's a lot more variety. So any puppy parents out there, if you've already tried all the puppy brands like I did with Sophie, just know that once your puppy reaches adulthood, there's so many other choices. For Sophie, we found a brand that makes smaller sized pieces of dog food, so it's purposely made for small breeds, and I can tell just from her eating it that it's a lot easier for her to chew and digest the smaller pieces rather than the big pieces. I honestly think that the fact that because the pieces are smaller, she is more inclined to eat it rather than just kind of push it around the bowl and only eat a couple of pieces because the food is now suited to her teeth and to her body. The second thing I would suggest you doing is trying out toppers. I've talked about this before, adding wholesome ingredients that you may have cooked at home, like cooked vegetables that are dog friendly at the pet store. You can also buy like a food dust that you can sprinkle on top. There's also wet dog food that you can mix in as well. Try these things out. Just beware that adding these toppers is a great idea, and if it works for you, that's awesome, but your puppy or dog may reach a point where it no longer works for them anymore, like Sophie did. It doesn't matter what I put in her food, she'll just suck on the kibble and spit it back out just to get all the vegetables from her food, and that's it. So just be aware that could be a possibility that you may reach a point that no matter how many toppers you use, your dog just has decided not to eat anymore, and then you'll be back at square one. So the topper option is a great idea, but it doesn't work for everybody. My third tip before I reveal the tool that's been working really well for Sophie is to use puzzle toys or snuffle mats. They're a really great way to engage your dog mentally, and they keep things new and exciting. Make sure that you use these puzzle toys and snuffle mats wisely. I know that they're not cheap, and adding in all these new toys can be costly. If I were to use these every single day, Sophie would get bored of them. I just know she would. And I've tried out using the snuffle mat like 3 days in a row at dinner, and it works the first night, and the next two nights it doesn't work. So I only use the puzzle feeder and the snuffle mat about maybe 2 or 3 times a week. And you can continue to use it as an awesome tool to engage your dog with eating their food. Now here's the number one tool that is currently working for Sophie. So I've started this maybe about 2 or 3 months ago, and I really wanted to see if it would continue working. The thing that we've been using is her crate. I've documented our experience with crate training with Sophie on this channel before, and right now we only really use her crate for her to sleep in. Until about 2 or 3 months ago, where I kind of went back on what I remembered from her training. So when I first brought her home, the idea was to have her eating in her crate because it was really great for forming positive emotions with crate training. What I started to see was that she was really great in her crate. There was no issues. Everything was working great until what started happening was I would pour her food up and she would just be sitting by us at the dinner table and she wouldn't be eating her food. I tried out a few things. I tried not giving her any treats, both human treats and dog treats, to see if that would motivate her more to eat, but that did nothing. And then I thought, why not control her area of where she's eating? So I decided on getting out her crate and using that as a tool to get her to eat. Now what I do is I get the crate out when it's breakfast and dinner time. I pour her food in her bowl. I tell her to go into her crate and then she goes into her crate. Does she eat right away when she goes into her crate? No, this is not a magical solution. This does not get rid of her pickiness. She's still a picky eater. I don't know why it's working. There must be some sort of connection for her that when she's in that space or when she's in the crate, something kicks in for her to eat. It has taken away a lot of the stress and worry. I've shared with you guys other tips on how to get your puppy to eat, and this is honestly the least stressful, the least amount of work as well, because I don't have to do anything to her food. Sophie, are you all done eating? Did you eat your food?
Good girl.
If you still have your crate at home and you have a picky eater, try out this tip, because I am honestly curious to find out whether it is just a Sophie thing or if this is something that works for other dogs as well. I don't know what it is. I am all for it, and I am all for sharing this information with you guys if it helps you, if you also have a picky eater as well. So for those of you who are watching this video because you are looking for solutions and tips on how to get your puppy or your dog to eat, try out the tips I mentioned earlier. And if you have a crate, try out this tool, because it's the only thing that's working for Sophie right now. And I've tried out a lot of things. I really hope you guys found this video informative and helpful. If you have any questions or if you want to share your own experience, please message me down below. If you enjoyed this video, please leave us a like and don't forget to subscribe so you can support our channel and hit that notification bell so you can be notified of any new content we post. Thank you so much for watching and thank you to all of those that have subscribed and supported our channel so far. You guys are amazing. All right, I'm going to say bye for now. Until next time. Bye, guys.
Sophie, want to say bye? Bye, guys. Good luck.